On a beautiful natural texture, this Klimt-inspired look uses reverse graduation and freehand techniques combined with gorgeous new tones to create a highly visual, ethereal shape. Before commencing the haircut, make a thorough assessment of all the hairline growth patterns. Also, take time to pre-visualize the shape to be created. Divide the hair as shown. Distinct panels that will alternate between shorter and more graphical areas around the perimeter, with larger interior areas that will be cut with reverse graduation to give an expanded silhouette. To start, take a horizontal section in the nape, lift the hair straight out and cut a square line that will sit level with the bottom of the ear. The next section is taken in the same manner as the first and cut using the first section as a guide. Take a vertical section and, using the previously cut nape hair as a guide, cut a vertical line that follows the head shape. Take a parallel section and cut using the first section as a guide. Now take a horizontal section through the temple and, using the previously cut hair as a guide, cut a line that follows the shape of the head. Now take a parallel section and cut by combing the hair up onto the first section. The rest of the hair in this area is cut in the same manner. Now refine the nape hairline with scissor over comb to establish a stronger edge. Gently refine the outline shape behind the ear. Define the outline shape through the side by holding the hair in the comb and cut a square line. Define the side hairline by cutting a diagonal line. Now remove any excess weight through the outline by rounding the corner. The underneath of the second side is cut using horizontal sections to remove weight from the hair. Behind the ear, take vertical sections and flatten the shape through. As in the first side, blend the sections with the previously cut nape hair. Continue with all the hair in this area. Now define a stronger outline shape. Work gently around the front and nape hairlines to help define the shape. Now work on the large oblong section through the back. Take a horizontal section and after assessing the length to be created, cut a square line at that point. Now take a parallel section, comb the hair down, and allow the fingers to slide slightly past the original cutting line, in this instance about half a finger's width. This is the key to the reverse graduation technique and will produce a very steep graduated effect. The next section is cut in the same way, once again allowing the cutting line to fall lower than the guide. Continue up to the crown using the same cutting method. Now take horizontal sections and using the previously cut hair as a guide, cut a square line at that point. With this technique, it's important to assess the shape visually, though a more accurate assessment will only be possible when the hair is drier. Continue taking parallel sections and extend the reverse graduation cutting technique from the back. Always use the corresponding section through the back as a guide. Now watch how the sections continue up and over the head to the original low side parting. Once again, take time to assess the shape visually. Now execute the same reverse graduation technique through the second side. Use the corresponding section behind the ear as a guide and extend the line through the front. Now continue with the reverse graduation technique up to a center parting. This will give an even weight distribution no matter which way the hair is dressed. Prior to commencing the fringe, assess the shape created so far and allow the hair to dry. The fringe area is cut in a freehand manner to establish a clean, strong, curved line that skims the eyebrow through one side and drops down onto the cheekbone through the second side, giving a dramatic feel to the shape. Here is the completed shape prior to colouring. Prior to colouring, section the hair as shown. The hair has been divided into two main areas, which constitute the perimeter section, and the interior sections, which form a rounded square. There is also a fine right angular section dividing the two main areas. The first colour is applied to the perimeter area and is a combination of 60 ml of 9/4 very light blonde and 30 ml of 8/2 light blonde gold with 6% colour develop. Once complete, isolate this area with acetate. This will allow the colour to be observed as it processes. Now pre-lighten the fine right angular section employing a back-to-back slice technique using white up and 6% colour develop. Continue with the same back-to-back slicing technique around the front part of the section. Through the top area. This has been divided into a series of L-shaped sections and is coloured using three alternating combinations. The first is 9/5, a very light blonde and 9% colour develop, applied with a regular tint application technique. Once again, protect this area with acetate. Notice how this section forms an L shape around the previously coloured square area. Now colour this section using 12/5 Crema Blonde Violet and 12% colour develop. As before, isolate this area with acetate. Now work on the next section, which forms a larger L shape around the previous one. Return to the first colour, the 9/5 Very Light Blonde with 9% colour develop combination. Once again, isolate the section with an acetate sheet. The next section forms a larger L shape and provides a link between the perimeter and the interior colours by using the original perimeter formula of 60 ml of 9/4 Very Light Blonde and 30 ml of 8/2 Light Blonde Gold with 6% colour develop. Now progress through the whole top area, alternating the three chosen colours. The final colour in the top section is the same colour as the perimeter. This is to provide continuity and a visual blend either side of the pre-light and slice section. Protect this section and allow the whole head to process. Divide the pre-lightened section into two and tone using two distinct accent colours. The first, which will be placed in the underneath of the section, is a combination of 15 ml of clear intensitone and 15 ml of green intensitone with 3% colour develop. This is applied using a back-to-back slicing technique. Continue with this colour around the underneath of the front of the section. The second colour to be used is a combination of 15 ml of 9/4, a very light blonde red, with 5 ml of pink intensitone and 5 ml of gold intensitone with 3% colour develop. Apply this throughout the rest of the pre-lightened area. Now allow the colours to process. Prior to colouring, section the hair as shown. The hair has been divided into two main areas, which constitute the perimeter section, and the interior sections, which form a rounded square. There is also a fine right angular section dividing the two main areas. The first colour is applied to the perimeter area and is a combination of 60 ml of 9/4 very light blonde and 30 millilitres of 8/2 light blonde gold with 6% colour develop. Once complete, isolate this area with acetate. This will allow the colour to be observed as it processes. Now pre-lighten the fine right angular section employing a back-to-back slice technique using white up and 6% colour develop. Continue with the same back-to-back slicing technique around the front part of the section. Thank you. work through the top area. This has been divided into a series of L-shaped sections and is coloured using three alternating combinations. The first is 9/5, a very light blonde, and 9% colour develop, applied with a regular tint application technique. Once again, protect this area with acetate. Notice how this section forms an L shape around the previously coloured square area. Now colour this section using 12/5 Crema Blonde Violet and 12% colour develop. As before, isolate this area with acetate. Now work on the next section, which forms a larger L shape around the previous one. Return to the first colour, the 9/5 Very Light Blonde with 9% Colour Develop combination. Once again, isolate the section with an acetate sheet. The next section forms a larger L shape and provides a link between the perimeter and the interior colours by using the original perimeter formula of 60 ml of 9/4 Very Light Blonde and 30 ml of 8/2 Light Blonde Gold with 6% colour develop. Now progress through the whole top area, alternating the three chosen colours. The final colour in the top section is the same colour as the perimeter. This is to provide continuity and a visual blend either side of the pre-lightened slice section. Protect this section and allow the whole head to process. Divide the pre-lightened section into two and tone using two distinct accent colours. The first, which will be placed in the underneath of the section, is a combination of 15 ml of clear intensitone and 15 ml of green intensitone with 3% colour develop. This is applied using a back-to-back slicing technique. Thank you. Continue with this color around the underneath of the front of the section. The second colour to be used is a combination of 15 millilitres of 9/4, a very light blonde red, with 5 millilitres of pink intensitone and 5 millilitres of gold intensitone with 3% colour develop. Apply this throughout the rest of the pre-lightened area. Now allow the colours to process. Prior to colouring, section the hair as shown. The hair has been divided into two main areas, which constitute the perimeter section, and the interior sections, which form a rounded square. There is also a fine right angular section dividing the two main areas. The first colour is applied to the perimeter area and is a combination of 30 millilitres of 9/7, very light brunette blonde, and 30 millilitres of 8/3/4, light gold red blonde, with 6% Welloxen Perfect. Once complete, isolate this area with acetate. This will allow the colour to be observed as it processes. Now pre-lighten the fine right angular section, employing a back-to-back slice technique. Use blonde or cream and 6% Welloxen Perfect. Thank you. Continue with the same back-to-back slicing technique around the front part of the section. Now work through the top area. This has been divided into a series of L-shaped sections and is coloured using three alternating combinations. The first is 9-stroke-1-6, a very light ash violet blonde and 9% well oxen perfect, applied with a regular tint application technique. Once again, protect this area with acetate. Notice how this section forms an L shape around the previously coloured square area. Now colour this section using 12-stroke-6-1 Special Violet Ash Blonde and 12% Well Oxen Perfect. As before, isolate this area with acetate. Now work on the next section, which forms a larger L shape around the previous one. Return to the first colour, 9-stroke-1-6, a very light ash violet blonde and 9% Well Oxen Perfect combination. Once again, isolate the section with an acetate sheet. The next section forms a larger L shape and provides a link between the perimeter and the interior colours by using the original perimeter formula of 30 ml of 9-stroke-7 very light brunette blonde and 30 ml of 8-stroke-3-4 light gold red blonde with 6% Well Oxen Perfect. Now progress through the whole top area, alternating the three chosen colours. Colour in the top section is the same colour as the perimeter. This is to provide continuity and a visual blend either side of the pre-lightened slice section. Protect this section and allow the whole head to process. Divide the pre-lightened section into two and tone using two distinct accent colours. The first, which will be placed in the underneath of the section, is a combination of 20 ml of 10/0 lightest blonde and 5 ml of 0/28 petrol special mix and Wellox and Perfect pastel. This is applied using a back-to-back slicing technique. Continue with this colour around the underneath of the front of the section. The second colour to be used is a combination of 15 ml of 9/7, a very light brunette blonde, with 5 ml of 0/65, pink special mix, and Wellox and Perfect pastel. Apply this throughout the rest of the pre-lightened area. allow the colors to process. The finished result, a sublime combination of innovative cutting techniques to produce the most extraordinary shape, and luxurious colours of corals and golds accented with a decadent flash of emerald. Prior to commencing the haircut, divide the hair as shown, a large curved asymmetrical triangle. Divide the hair vertically from the apex of the triangle, then take a horizontal section just below the disconnected top area. Now cut a line that follows the shape of the head at the desired length. Take a fine diagonal section around the front hairline and allow this to drop away. Behind this, take a parallel section and cut a line that follows the shape of the head, using the previously cut horizontal section as a guide. Now work across the side of the head using the same sectioning and cutting procedure. Of the head is reached, start to allow a slim panel of the nape hairline to drop away. This will be refined at a later stage. Thank you. Notice how the sections become more vertical through the centre back. Progress the sections across the back of the head. Make sure that the same density of the hairline is dropped out on the second side. Now work on the crown area and the second side of the haircut. Start by taking vertical sections and continue the line from the underneath sections. Gradually pivot the sections so they remain vertical through the second side. Take a horizontal section and cut down into the front hairline. Now continue by taking parallel sections and over-directing the hair very slightly up. Cut using the previous section as a guide. The sections will need to pivot slightly to incorporate the side area. Now return to the first side to blend the previously disconnected hairline. Take diagonal sections and cut a line that follows the cheekbone, still retaining extra length through the front. Refine the graduation created through the edge by cutting a line against the skin. After the outline through the back has been defined in the same way as the side, establish a stronger edge through the hairline. Now work on the lengths through the top. Divide the hair around the hairline and cut a sharp bowed fringe to the desired length. Subsequent sections are over-directed forward onto this line. Continue taking parallel sections and blend any hair that reaches down onto the guideline. Now take a vertical section along the head and, using the fringe as a guide, cut a line from long to short. The rest of the hair through the top is cut using the first section as a guide. Take time to assess the shape created so far. Thank you. Now work on the second side of the top, lift the hair up, and cut a line that follows the shape of the head using the underneath graduation as a guide. Now work on the pre-light and longer panel. Lift the hair straight up and back and cut a line from short to long. This length can vary depending on the effect required. Subsequent sections are cut using the first as a guide. Time to comb the hair and assess any areas that need refining. After drying, refine the crown area by using a pointing technique. Refine the fringe area through the comb. And here is the finished result. A delightful combination of inspirational imagery and precision technique, accented with rich, lustrous colour. Before commencing, make a thorough assessment of all the hairline growth patterns. Prior to commencing the colour, divide the hair as shown, an offset oblong shape with a triangular section taken out around the crown. First, tint all the underneath sections with a combination of 60 ml of 4/5, which is a medium brown violet, and 5 ml of 2/7, a blue-black with 6% colour develop. This colour is applied to the top of the section first, and then the remaining area using a normal tint application procedure. Isolate this area with clear acetate sheets. These enable the color to be observed as it develops. Notice that the top area has been subdivided into three smaller sections. Colour the first of these sections using a mixture of 15 ml of 5/5 of light brown violet with 15 ml of Sickman Intensitone and 6% colour develop. Divide the second section into smaller square sections as shown and tint by rotating the following three colours. The first colour is a combination of 60 ml of 4/5 medium brown violet and 5 ml of 2/7 blue black and 6% colour develop. Note that this is the same colour used in the underneath section. Isolate each of these sections with acetate. The second colour used is a combination of 15 ml of blue Intensitone and 15 ml of Cyclamen Intensitone with 6% colour develop. The third colour used is 15 ml of 5/5, a light brown violet, with 15 ml of Cyclamen Intensitone and 6% colour develop. Now isolate this area. Now divide three more sections, which will be coloured by alternating the original three colours. The key to this technique is to ensure that the same colour is never placed on an adjacent section. After isolating this section, continue to the front hairline, rotating the colours as desired. Now colour the remaining thin triangular section, which was pre-lightened using White Up and 3% colour develop. Alternate the following two colours for this area. The first colour used is 15 ml of Cyclamen Intensitone and 3% colour develop. Colour is a combination of 10 ml of blue intensitone with 10 ml of cyclamen intensitone mixed with 3% colour develop. Now continue to the front hairline, alternating the chosen colours. Now allow to process. Before commencing, make a thorough assessment of all the hairline growth patterns. Prior to commencing the colour, divide the hair as shown, an offset oblong shape with a triangular section taken out around the crown. First, tint all the underneath sections with a combination of 60 ml of 4/5, which is a medium brown violet, and 5 ml of 2/7, a blue-black with 6% colour develop. This colour is applied to the top of the section first, and then the remaining area using a normal tint application procedure. Isolate this area with clear acetate sheets. These enable the colour to be observed as it develops. Notice that the top area has been subdivided into three smaller sections. Colour the first of these sections using a mixture of 15 ml of 5/5 of light brown violet with 15 ml of Cyclamen Intensitone and 6% colour develop. Divide the second section into smaller square sections as shown and tint by rotating the following three colours. The first colour is a combination of 60 millilitres of 4/5 medium brown violet and 5 millilitres of 2/7 blue black and 6% colour develop. Note that this is the same colour used in the underneath section. Isolate each of these sections with acetate. The second colour used is a combination of 15 millilitres of blue intensitone and 15 millilitres of cyclamen intensitone with 6% colour develop. The third colour used is 15 millilitres of 5/5, a light brown violet, with 15 millilitres of cyclamen intensitone and 6% colour develop. Now isolate this area. Now divide three more sections, which will be coloured by alternating the original three colours. The key to this technique is to ensure that the same colour is never placed on an adjacent section. After isolating this section, continue to the front hairline, rotating the colours as desired. Now colour the remaining thin triangular section, which was pre-lightened using white up and 3% colour develop. Alternate the following two colours for this area. The first colour used is 15 millilitres of cyclamen intensitone and 3% colour develop. Thank you. second colour is a combination of 10 millilitres of blue intenser tone with 10 millilitres of cyclamen intenser tone, mixed with 3% colour develop. Now continue to the front hairline, alternating the chosen colours. Now allow to process. Before commencing, make a thorough assessment of all the hairline growth patterns. Prior to commencing the colour, divide the hair as shown, an offset oblong shape with a triangular section taken out around the crown. First, tint all the underneath sections with a combination of 60 millilitres of 3/66, which is a dark intense violet with 9% Welloxen Perfect. This colour is applied to the top of the section first and then the remaining area using a normal tint application procedure. Isolate this area with clear acetate sheets. These enable the colour to be observed as it develops. Notice that the top area has been subdivided into three smaller sections. Colour the first of these sections using a mixture of 20 millilitres of 5/5/65 of light intense violet mahogany brown with 5 millilitres of 0/65 pink special mix and 6% Welloxen Perfect. Divide the second section into smaller square sections as shown and tint by rotating the following three colours. The first colour is a combination of 60 millilitres of 3/66 dark intense violet and 9% Welloxen Perfect. Note that this is the same colour used in the underneath section. Isolate each of these sections with acetate. The second colour used is a combination of 15 millilitres of 0/88 blue special mix and 15 millilitres of 0/65 pink special mix with 6% Welloxen Perfect. The third colour used is 15 ml of 55/65, a light intense violet mahogany brown, with 15 ml of 0/65 pink special mix and 6% Well Oxen Perfect. Now isolate this area. Now divide three more sections, which will be coloured by alternating the original three colours. The key to this technique is to ensure that the same colour is never placed on an adjacent section. After isolating this section, continue to the front hairline, rotating the colours as desired. Now colour the remaining thin triangular section, which was pre-lightened using Blonde or Cream and 6% Well Oxen Perfect. Alternate the following two colours for this area. The first colour used is 15 ml of 0/65 Pink Special Mix and Well Oxen Perfect Pastel. The second colour is a combination of 10 ml of 0/88 Blue Special Mix with 10 ml of 0/65 Pink Special Mix and Well Oxen Perfect Pastel. Now continue to the front hairline, alternating the chosen colours. Now allow to process. intricate shape is totally inspired by the artist Egon Schiele, incorporating a fitted graduated shape through the interior with delicate borders of exterior length and larger disconnected panels of length through the top. Cyclamen with a flash of belladonna completes the sculpted look. This intricate shape is totally inspired by the artist Egon Schiele, incorporating a fitted graduated shape through the interior with delicate borders of exterior length and larger disconnected panels of length through the top. Cyclamen with a flash of belladonna completes the sculpted look. Superb technique is required to produce this resolutely modern men's look, where an internal graduated step creates a shape that's inspired by the artist Egon Schiele and is complemented by metallic climped. Divide the hair vertically, then horizontally, comb the hair down, and cut a square line at the desired length. This will form the guide for the internal step. Now extend this line into the back. Notice how the fingers angle away from the head to produce more graduation through the back. Continue the line into the rear corner of the head. Now remove the hair beneath the graduated line by taking diagonal sections and cut a line that works from short to long. Take parallel sections and work through the whole of the side area. Starts to curve into the back, start over directing forward slightly more. This will allow for the longer length towards the corner. Now refine the shape so far using a scissor over comb technique. Now blend the graduated lengths from the second side into the previously cut line of weight from the first side. Take a vertical section and cut a line from the lengths created through the crown area into the corner of the step. Subsequent sections are pivoted to allow the hair to be over-directed onto the previous one. Refine this area by cutting a line from the corner of the step and blend back into the previously cut hair through the nape. Refine all the hairline lengths with a combination of graduation, scissor overcomb, and finally clipper overcomb. Blend the internal lengths onto the graduated step. Take a horizontal section and, combing the hair gently down onto the guide, cut a line at that point. To achieve greater length, notice how the line becomes disconnected above and in front of the ear. Subsequent sections are taken parallel, combed down and cut using the first sections as the guide. Notice though that the hair is elevated to keep the line from becoming too heavy. Now refine the graduation vertically, initially just rounding the very tip of the corner. Now with parallel sections, remove slightly more, though continue to over-direct the hair back to allow greater length through the front hairline. finished shape prior to colouring. Prior to colouring, divide a small asymmetrical diamond shape through the heavier side of the haircut. This area will contain the accent colours, so care should be taken with regard to placement and size. This diamond section is pre-lightened using White Up and 6% Colour Develop and is applied with a back-to-back slice technique. Once the pre-lightened area is complete, colour the remaining hair using a classic tint application technique. The colour used is a combination of 45ml of 4, a medium brown, and 15ml of 5/8, medium brown grey, with 6% colour develop. Carefully work around the pre-lightened foils. Use gentle brush strokes through the scissor over combed areas. Now allow to process. After processing, divide the pre-lightened area into a series of interlocking L-shaped sections as shown. The first colour to be used is a combination of 15ml of blue Intensitone with 4ml of 2/7, a blue-black, and 3% colour develop. Use a back-to-back slicing technique. Complete the first reversed L shape by working across the back of the pre-lightened section. The second colour to be used comprises of 15 ml of blue intenser tone and 6% colour develop. Once again, use a back-to-back slicing technique. Because of the diamond nature of the pre-lightened section and the previous two L shapes, the final section is square in shape. Colour the remaining hair using 10 ml of 9/8, a very light grey blonde, and 10 ml of blue intenser tone with 3% colour develop. Now allow the colours to process. Prior to colouring, divide a small asymmetrical diamond shape through the heavier side of the haircut. This area will contain the accent colours, so care should be taken with regard to placement and size. This diamond section is pre-lightened using white up and 6% colour develop and is applied with a back-to-back slice technique. Once the pre-lightened area is complete, colour the remaining hair using a classic tint application technique. The colour used is a combination of 45 ml of 4, a medium brown, and 15 ml of 5/8, medium brown grey, with 6% colour develop. Carefully work around the pre-lightened foils. Use gentle brush strokes through the scissor over combed areas. Now allow to process. After processing, divide the pre-lightened area into a series of interlocking L-shaped sections as shown. The first colour to be used is a combination of 15 ml of blue Intensitone with 4 ml of 2/7, a blue-black, and 3% colour develop. Use a back-to-back slicing technique. Complete the first L shape by working across the back of the pre-lightened section. The second colour to be used comprises of 15 ml of blue Intensitone and 6% colour develop. Once again, use a back-to-back slicing technique. Thank you. because of the diamond nature of the pre-Lytton section and the previous two L shapes, the final section is square in shape. Colour the remaining hair using 10 ml of 9/8, a very light grey blonde, and 10 ml of blue intensitone with 3% colour develop. Now allow the colours to process. Prior to colouring, divide a small asymmetrical diamond shape through the heavier side of the haircut. This area will contain the accent colours, so care should be taken with regard to placement and size. This diamond section is pre-lightened using blonde or cream and 6% Welloxen Perfect and is applied with a back-to-back slice technique. Once the pre-lightened area is complete, colour the remaining hair using a classic tint application technique. The colour used is a combination of 45 ml of 4/0 medium brown and 15 ml of 5/1 light ash brown with 6% Welloxen Perfect. Work around the pre-lightened foils. Use gentle brush strokes through the scissor over combed areas. Now allow to process. After processing, divide the pre-lightened area into a series of interlocking L-shaped sections as shown. The first colour to be used is a combination of 15 ml of 0/88 Blue Special Mix, with 4 millilitres of 2-stroke 8, a black pearl and Wellox Imperfect Pastel. Use a back-to-back slicing technique. Complete the first L shape by working across the back of the pre-lightened section. The second colour to be used comprises of 15 millilitres of 0-88 Blue Special Mix and 6% Wellox Imperfect. Once again, use a back-to-back slicing technique. Because of the diamond nature of the pre-lightened section and the previous two L shapes, the final section is square in shape. Colour the remaining hair using 10 millilitres of 9-stroke 1, a very light ash blonde, and 10 millilitres of 0-stroke 88 Blue Special Mix and Wellox Imperfect Pastel. Now allow the colours to process. And the finished result? A refreshingly modern take on a classic men's look, accented with masculine colour. Welcome to our new DVD entitled Metropolis Now, which celebrates the radical modernity of the 21st century cityscape. This is a new approach to modernism, as architects of the new millennium are inspired by the flowing forms and rhythms of nature. International creative director Mark Hayes points out this is about making new shapes, about modern architects doing extraordinary things that can be translated into incredible hair. Welcome to the new collection from Sassoon, Neon Blitz, which puts neon straight back into fashion's palette. Neon Blitz rejects the rigid conformity of celebrity style in favour of a modern zeitgeist fresh out of London's clubland. A useful union of art, fashion and music, all bathed in a dazzling light of full-on fluorine. Edgy panelled cuts with dramatic fins of disconnection, a strobe lit with cyber glow, creating streamlined flashes of super-accurate, hyper-real colour. By sampling and radically remixing the 80s, a new psychedelic language of luminous neon brights is created. It's the day the world turned day-glow. Welcome to our new collection, Spiral, a collection of contradictions, strong yet soft, combining geometry and the irregular, shot through with a fresh, bright palette of cyclamen, orange, blue and lavender. Spiral celebrates hair as art. Strongly geometric cuts are softened with lengths of layered panels that push the shapes out by adding trailing veils and movement, a compelling combination of feminine strength and softness. Spiral, a collection that is cutting edge yet quintessentially Sassoon. Welcome to the ABC Technical Cutting Series. Contained within are the techniques that form the foundation for the world-renowned training method of cutting hair the Sassoon way. Lines, graduation and layering are fully explained and demonstrated in their purest form, with variations to show how these three fundamental techniques combine to produce essential contemporary shapes that will boost any stylist's repertoire. The Sassoon collection for this season, Geoganic, sees a renaissance of organic modernism in contemporary design. In a series of shapes and tones inspired by the secessionist artists Egon Schiele and Gustav Klimt, and Wiener Werkstätte designers Joseph Hoffmann and Koloman Moser. The looks are diametrically cut and coloured to create paradoxically oppositional effects, says Sassoon International creative director Mark Hayes. We're using ergometric methods to create effects that are geometric when flat and when ruffled have volume in unexpected ways. Colour is trigonomic with abstract squares, sinuous lines and L-shaped sections, which are then subtly toned with cyclamen, violet, mulberry, gold or coral, then accented with a vibrant flash of belladonna or emerald green. The new collection, Geoganic, where natural forms interact with geometric modernity, sees us soon leading a new style revolution.